In this video, we're continuing on with the Factoring Trinomials worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Algebra 1 section. This is also known as Factoring Quadratic Polynomials, hard. Picking up where we left off with number 7, our a is 7, our b is 53, and our c is 28. So we're multiplying a and c together to get 7 times 28. That's going to equal 196. Now we're going to find which two numbers multiply to give us 196, but add to give us 53. Writing down the factors of 196, we have 1 and 196, we have 2 and 98, we have 4 and 49, 7 and 28, and then 14 and 14. However, the two factors that add to give us 53 are 4 and 49. So now we're going to rewrite this polynomial, splitting up 53a. So we'll have 7a squared plus 4a plus 49a plus 28. 4a plus 49a is 53a. We're still adding that to 7a squared and 28. Our next step will be to group the first two terms and the second two terms together, and then find the greatest common factor between each of those. So the greatest common factor in this first one is a. So a will get multiplied to 7a and 4. And you can see that a times 7a is 7a squared, and a times 4 is 4a. And that will be added to the greatest common factor between 49a and 28 is 7. So when we pull 7 out, 7 times 7a is 49a, and 7 times 4 is 28. Now you can see that we have two binomials that are the same for each term. So we'll pull out that binomial. So taking out 7a plus 4, we would multiply that by a plus 7. A plus 7. And that is our solution in number 7. 7a plus 4 times a plus 7. And if you were confused through any step, leave a comment below or go back to the previous video where I went through the steps more in depth. But going through the steps quickly one more time, we're multiplying a and c. Then we're factoring that quantity a times c and looking for the two numbers that add to give us b. And that is how we're splitting up the polynomial. And then once we do that, we'll group the first two terms and the second two terms, factor out the greatest common factor of each of those groups, and then we can factor out the common binomial to get that factored solution. Now number 8 is slightly different. In number 8, we can pull out a number at the very start. 9, 66, and 21 all have a 3 in common. So pulling out a 3 at the start, we'll get 3k squared plus 22k plus 7. Now our a is 3, our b is 22, and our c is 7. So a times c is equal to 3 times 7, which is 21. So what two numbers multiply to give us 21 and add to give us 22? Our first factor is 1 and 21, and we can stop writing factors there because 1 plus 21 does indeed equal 22. So now we're going to rewrite 3k squared plus 22k plus 7. That'll be 3k squared plus 1k plus 21k plus 7. And remember, that entire thing is multiplied by 3. Now we're going to group, grouping the first two terms in our polynomial and the second two terms in our polynomial together. Pulling out the greatest common factor in the first grouping is k. So that'll be k, and that gets multiplied to 3k plus 1. In the second grouping, our greatest common factor is 7, and that will get multiplied to 3k to give us 21, and 1 to give us 7. But remember, this entire term is multiplied by 3. And since we have a common binomial, we can factor that out. So we'll have 3k plus 1 times k plus 7, and those are both multiplied by 3. So 3 times 3k plus 1 times k plus 7 is the solution in number 8. And if you're more comfortable dropping the 3 from the beginning, just remember to add it back in at the end. And number 9, again, we have a greatest common factor between each of the terms. And that greatest common factor is 3. So we're going to pull 3 out. So that'll leave us with 5n squared minus 9n minus 2. Our a is 5, b is negative 9, and c is negative 2. So multiplying a and c together, we'll get 5 times negative 2, which is a negative 10. The factors of 10 are 1, 10, 2, and 5. So what adds to give us a negative 9? That will be 1 and negative 10. That equals negative 9, and 1 times negative 10 equals negative 10. So like I just suggested, I'm going to drop this 3. However, I'm going to write it so that I remember that it needs to go in my final answer. So in all of my next steps, I know that 3 is technically multiplied to those. So rewriting 5n squared minus 9n minus 2 as 5n squared plus 1n minus or plus a negative 10n minus 2. Grouping the first two terms together and the second two terms together, remembering that this entire thing is multiplied by 3, I'm going to pull out my common factor, which is n, so I'll have 5n plus 1, and I'm going to pull out my common factor, which is negative 2. So I'll have 5n plus 1 as well. I put out a negative 2 as opposed to a positive 2, so that I have 5n plus 1, and then 5n plus 1. And remember, this entire thing is technically multiplied by 3. So now I can factor out that 5n plus 1, so it'll be 5n plus 1 times n minus 2. And remembering to multiply that by 3, my final solution is 3 times 5n plus 1 times n minus 2. So in number 9, the steps are just a little clearer when we drop the 3 in the beginning and multiply it back in the end. If you look up at number 8, you can see that we just have to deal with more parentheses. So whatever you feel most comfortable doing, use that method. In number 10, there is not a greatest common factor among the terms. Therefore, our a is 5, our b is negative 18, and our c is 9. A times c is 5 times 9, which gives us 45. The factors of 45 are 1 and 45, 3, 15, 5, and 9. So what adds to give us negative 18? Negative 3 plus negative 15 will add to give us negative 18, and negative 3 times negative 15 is indeed a positive 45. So we're going to rewrite our polynomial as 5x squared plus negative 3x plus negative 15x plus 9. Grouping the first two terms together and the second two terms together, pulling out our GCF of x in the first term, we'll have 5x plus negative 3, or minus 3. And then our GCF in the second two terms is 3, but I'm going to make that a negative 3 so that we can get 5x minus 3. Since negative 3 times 5x is negative 15, and negative 3 times 3 is negative 9, but if we're subtracting a negative, it's the same as adding a positive. Now, pulling out that common binomial or factoring it out, I'll have 5x minus 3 times x minus 3. And that's my solution in number 10. In number 11, I do not have a greatest common factor between a, b, and c. So a is 4, b is negative 15, and c is negative 25. A times c is 4 times negative 25, which is negative 100. Factoring 100, I'll have 1 and 100, 2 and 50, 4 and 25, 5 and 20, and then 10 and 10. So what two numbers add to give me negative 15? That will be 5 and negative 20. 5 times negative 20 is negative 100, and 5 minus 20 is negative 15. So rewriting our polynomial as 4n squared plus 5n plus negative 20n plus negative 25 or minus 25, however you feel more comfortable writing it. Grouping the first two terms together and the last two terms together, 4n squared plus 5n, the common factor is n, so I'll have 4n plus 5, and for negative 20n plus negative 25, the common factor is negative 5. So then I'll have positive 4n plus a positive 5. So my final solution, I'll have 4n plus 5 times n minus 5. And remember, multiplication is commutative. So the order in which we write our multiplication doesn't matter. So I could say n minus 5 times 4n plus 5. That is also an acceptable answer because they are equivalent. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 12. Before I go over the answer to this, move that mouse over and click that thumbs up button. That lets me know that you found this video helpful. Now that you've done that, on to number 12. Our A is 4, our B is negative 35, and our C is 49. A times C is 4 times 49, which is 196. The factors of 196 are 1 and 196, 2 and 98, 4, 49, 7, 28, and 14 and 14. So what adds to give us a negative 35? Negative 7 plus negative 28 will equal negative 35. And negative 7 times negative 28 is a positive 196. So rewriting my polynomial, I'll have 4x squared plus negative 7x plus negative 28x plus a positive 49. Grouping the first two terms and the last two terms, I'll pull out an x from my first two terms, so that's 4x plus negative 7, or minus 7. And then in my next two terms, I'll pull out a negative 7. That way, I'll get 4x minus 7. I have a common binomial that I can now factor out. So I'll have x minus 7, and that will get multiplied to 4x minus 7. And you can see x times 4x minus 7, and then negative 7 times 4x minus 7. X minus 7 times 4x minus 7 is my solution in number 12. If you haven't already, click that subscribe button, and if you didn't click the like button before number 12, hopefully you feel inclined to click it now. Continue on to the next video, where I'll finish out this worksheet completing numbers 13 through 18.